Welcome, everybody. This is Category 5 Technology TV in its current state. We're going to call this episode number 646, but really it's just a couple of moments where we get to spend time with some of the Kickstarter supporters. Cat5.tv/kick if you want to find out more. And that would be a great way to support Category 5 Technology TV as we get out of this space and move into our new space at Studio E. So, full disclosure, we had a great time. We spent some time doing this, and we gave the whole kind of, we had a great meeting, didn't we, Sasha?
Yeah, we sure did. Good old
and Zoom, yeah, and Zoom didn't record. So here we are. This is our opportunity to just kind of let you guys in, those who are watching on demand, on some of the behind the scenes, what's going on here at the studio. Unfortunately, we don't have a recording of our first Zoom meeting from this evening. And it was
make,
awesome.
You know what, though? Make note of that. Be a part of Zoom meetings as they happen, and you'll never lose out on the opportunity to be part of that conversation.
That's it. I mean, we've got Marshman here. We've got BP9 here. Guys, how was our first Zoom meeting?
It was excellent. It was excellent. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
You threw Robbie now, under the bus a half a dozen times.
Oh, yeah. At least that. At least that. Well, here we are at Studio D. We've got things kind of ripped apart. We've got everything taken apart. And most of the stuff is boxed. I think we're doing pretty well getting everything packed up.
And by, you know what? Robbie's really generous. He says we are doing really well, but really he's done like 99.9% of the packing.
It's true.
So studio done.
Yeah.
Am I done?
You done with this place?
Oh yes.
Yeah. It's funny. Okay, so this is, I wanted to show you. Now we're getting sidetracked. But this is kind of all the stuff that is packed and ready to go. We're gonna move this into the truck and get out of here. We got some garbage, we got some boxes that we're sorting through. Studio done.
Yeah.
At first, I was like, it was devastating. Yeah, it was devastating to learn that we had to leave this place, but I think it was a real kick in the pants to realize that it's time to move on, it's time to grow the show, and it's an opportunity for us. So now I come here and I'm like, now that it's torn apart, I'm ready. I'm excited.
Yep.
And ready to move on to what's next for Category 5 Technology TV.
Now, can you quickly, Robbie, give us a comparison of the amount of space that's available from
Good
the...
point, BP9.
Mm-hmm.
Where have I heard that before?
Yeah. Kind of weird, eh?
Stop
All right,
it.
Bo's here. Stop hey, Bo. You're just saying how we had to redo this because the recording didn't work. Okay, so look at Studio D, okay? You can see me from a couple of angles here, a few angles. This is my good angle.
No.
We
can't
thanks,
take
Bill.
You anywhere, Robbie. Can't take you anywhere, I'm telling you.
I don't know. There's cameras all around. One of them's always looking at my butt. Over here, we've got my production space, okay? So this is where I used to produce the show. Then we've got like our original Studio D set. Over here is where we are currently shooting the show. So this is what you're familiar with. That's the brick wall over here. Hey, Bo. And then this is where the cameras sit. So they look this way. And this is our stand-up desk studio over there for production. And then we've got this sit-down area over here, which we sometimes use, but not too often because it only seats two.
So but it is lovely when we want to sit.
I really like it, yeah. Okay, so that's here. So this is about 490 square feet, almost exactly, right here, okay? Beyond here, we have our kind of kitchen area, which is like a fridge and coffee maker, microwave, stuff that we use the coffee maker a lot. The fridge is like cream and stuff. But
things for in the coffee.
Yes, yeah. And then here we used to have, and I say used to, I've simply moved them out into the foyer. Audience seating was here. So we had 10 audience seats, but how often do we use that?
So rarely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Six, flip your, Sasha, flip your mic down.
Oh.
She's learning, folks.
How come nobody told me to do that? What?
I heard you.
Because your mouth is up here in your head.
I'm new.
We used to have all the audience seating here, but we don't really use it. We don't have audience here, and we tried the March break special, but now we can't because of COPPA. So yeah. It's like it's just wasted space. So consider this all wasted space.
Wait,
then we have a bathroom.
COPPA?
COPPA, yeah. It's like a regulation that says that we can't do programming that's focused towards children under 13 years old.
Oh, wow.
So because of that, okay. Our March break special was moot.
Okay.
So
yeah.
So we can't do that anymore.
Okay. We can be family friendly. We just have to be like older family friendly.
We're calling it now where we used to be called family friendly. Now we are safe for work. Okay.
Wow. How politically correct is that?
Which is good because everybody is working from home. Where their families are.
It's essentially the same thing. It just we can't target young people because then we can't monetize.
Right.
Views.
That makes yeah.
Yeah. So that's a tough thing. Because I really like to provide that family friendly focus, but we just we can't afford it.
Yeah.
So that is what it is. So lose all this space for audience seating because we don't have an audience. We never do. So
no.
It really
yeah, when people space. Come to the studio, we make them be guests. Like
they're on
yeah, air.
When Bill was yeah. here, when Bo you're, was here, yeah. where were you standing? You were over here.
Yeah, right? You're
you
not allowed to be
the
audience.
In front of the camera. Yeah.
Where yeah. was my wife sitting?
Well, and true. When Dara was here, she can sit here, but we don't need 10 seats for Dara, right?
No.
So
no.
consider, right. So if we had, so at
true.
Studio E, if we had just a couple of fold-up
one.
Chairs, Bill, a couple of fold-up chairs, right?
Okay.
That we can just pull out when we need them. So consider that all this space is just wasted, okay? So throw this away. We don't need a bathroom because the new place has a public bathroom. So cut it off right here and say, okay, yes, the new space is smaller, 490 square feet. Versus the 690 that we have here. But we don't need all that space.
Okay? It's excessive. That's
yeah.
what I was always thinking.
So when the audience seating was certainly unused. So we ended up just putting our stuff on it when we got here, right?
Yeah.
Truth be told.
That is true. It was just
yeah.
odd shelves.
Yeah. So so essentially we're going to have the same amount of studio space, just not have audience seating space. And we don't have the same amount of space for like our kitchen area,
mm-hmm.
but we can just put that on like we've got a coffee maker and a fridge. We can That's just put that on a table. Yeah,
exactly. So there you go.
Nice.
Yeah.
Thank you, Robbie. Well done.
Thanks, BP9. Robert Koenig was also here joining us for our first run through our Zoom group meeting. Now I've got it figured out, and I know that I know how to make it work. We've got so many cameras around, and it ended up putting it on my phone instead of on the computer, so it didn't record, and so that was a little bit disappointing. But now we've got it recording. So, any other questions for me, folks, while we have time before Zoom cuts us off?
Who wants to ask about the insurance?
Okay, well let's
so
back
bad.
Up a little bit.
I'm
let's
so
back
bad.
Up a little bit. Can I explain? Okay, so
can we
those
get a
who
direct
are watching
answer this time.
Yes, thanks, Bill. Bill's like maybe Bill would like to explain it to us.
Our resident expert.
Yes. Well, he's been through the long explanation. Look, just know that it's been a weird time for all of us, and here at Studio D, it's no exception. Getting insurance has been odd for Studio E because my insurance broker has shut down because of COVID-19. So they're working from home. They're doing things like e-sign and taking much more time than it should take to get a quote. And so that's been really, really difficult for me. It's been probably the biggest stress that I've had beyond the actual eviction. Just realizing that, okay, I've paid our rent, I've paid our security deposit at the new location. in all essences, it is ours. However, they will not give me a key until I have insurance. So knowing all that and realizing that, okay, from my perspective, it seems like they're dragging their heels. They're like, I'm just not getting a quote from my insurance broker. But realistically, I understand and I'm empathetic to the fact that they're all trying to do their jobs as well as anyone else through this trying time. But for me, it's like what I have to do still goes on. I still have to be out of this space before the end of March. And in order to do that, I have to have access to my new space before the end of March. So finally, I did receive the quote today. So I requested the quote back on the first day of March. And here we are on the 18th. And I finally received the quote. There's a couple of things that need to be adjusted. I'm very confident that they're going to be able to quickly fix those. And I'll be able to e-sign those. So we're at an interesting time now where even though we're all going through this really difficult situation with COVID-19, where technology is allowing us to do things like e-signing things and they're able to fulfill insurance policies from home, even though their brokerage is closed. So it's been a bit of a scary time that way because I haven't known whether we're going to have insurance in time to be able to get out of here before the landlord changes the locks.
So, but it worked. It worked. It happened.
Yeah. Everything's working out. Yes.
Yes. See? You can e-sign for Studio E. Nice. It's a theme.
It's a sign. Yes.
I use Sasha. No.
I'm telling you, Sasha's the glass half full person every single time. I guarantee every time.
Glass three quarters full.
Ms. Optimism. Right. Ms.
My
optimism
cup overfloweth.
That works.
I should say, I don't know if you can see me on Sasha's camera here, but we are socially distancing.
Yes.
Yeah.
We are complying.
And sadly, that means I will not be able to come up at the end of the month to help you guys move.
I know. That actually breaks my heart. I saw a little memo in my email that said that you had canceled just as I was on my way out the door to go to work. And I was like, wah, wah. Aww. How do I glass half full this?
Yeah.
All right. Well, this is a situation. I mean, COVID-19 is a situation that none of us anticipated. Mm-hmm. And it falls... I think it falls at a, I mean, when can it fall at a good time, right? But it really falls at a really hard time for the show, for everything that's going on. I am concerned that maybe I'm not going to have enough hands to move us. What if the moving truck company is closed down? I don't know if I'm even going to be able to get a moving truck. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to get the keys to the studio to be able to move my stuff in. That stuff
and
is all...
everything. And it changes like day to day, hour to hour, what is going to happen, what isn't. And we're really having to live in the moment, just having faith that everything is going to work out. And it will.
It will.
Yes, it will. Yes, ma'am.
It will.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So. If anything I've seen so far is that the community is backing us. The mm-hmm. community loves what we're doing. And that to me is a huge encouragement. When I entered, like this month, I was very uncertain. And for me, this has represented our community showing that category 5 is wanted, is desired, and that you want to see us succeed and see us continue. And that has been a big uplifter for me. And we're gonna see it happen.
Yeah.
It's gonna happen. So Studio E is a go. We've got the lease. I've signed the lease.
That's it's you know, 9/10 of the way there. We just gotta have like,
yes, exactly.
Yeah. Today's the 18th and there's how many days in March? 31. I'm bad at math, but we're pretty much in Studio E already.
Sasha, glass half full, remember? Glass half
full. No, we're already there. This is what I'm saying. Like by April 1st. Like, we're practically doing this from Studio E, almost.
Yeah.
So Marshman mentioned that he's not going to be able to be here. And I do regret that very much because it really means a lot that a community member, a viewer of the show, a fan of the show is willing to come out and be a part of our move. And Marshman, even just the thought of that is like mm-hmm. that. Thank you, man. Like, I know that everything is out of our control right now.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
know that I understand that. But look around you. Look around right now. I think, like, I want the community to know, like, we're in good shape.
Oh,
we
yeah.
We don't have a lot of stuff. The biggest thing, Bill, that I have to move is this. Our server rack.
Right, which is funny because you just moved it in, so you should know how easy yeah. it is to move right back in.
Like, I think
that'll fit on the back of my pickup truck. No worries at all.
Exactly. Yeah, I can no lift worries. This up myself, oh, right? Sure. Oh. I got my coffee.
Oh, good.
And I'm lifting.
There you go.
Right?
No shenanigans.
No problem. I picked up a good cart.
Oh, a good like dolly.
Yeah.
That is nice.
Okay.
Oh.
So like I'm pretty set. So there you go.
There's no heavy lifting required. Dolly in tow. Nice.
So we're gonna make do. Everything's gonna work out just fine. So but you know, I just wanna say, and I know Zoom really limits us for time. And as I walk over here, I'm just kind of monitoring because the last time we got kind of cut off and then we lost our recording because it cut us off. So I want to be careful of that. But I want the community to know how much we appreciate all of your support through this Kickstarter campaign so far. Know that the Kickstarter campaign is still a go. And while Category 5 Technology TV is safe, thanks to the early contributors, everything that is raised from here on out is just going to improve our stance when it comes to Studio E. So that has to do with when I hire the contractor, how great are we going to be able to make the show? I really want to be able to do, I mean, Bo, you're there with us. You Hi. Know, you own Ameridroid.com and we all love your company. We love single board computers. We love the things that you're carrying and doing. I want to do more with those kinds of products. I want to be able to set up a proper set where we say, okay, this is our set where we're going to be doing unboxings and setting up single board computers and doing really cool product demonstrations and DIY projects and things like that. There's so much that we could be doing that we never dreamed of with this space because back then we didn't have those technologies. Remember, this was season 8 when we opened this studio. So we didn't have those technologies to work with that kind of grew while we were here. Now we've got a chance to build a studio, get a contractor in, set up a space that has our proper sets, the way that we currently are, the way that the show is evolving, and be able to focus on those technologies that we're really, really keen on. So I'm really very...
Awesome.
Yeah. I'm very focused on, like, where are we at right now? I think this is an opportunity for Category 5 to say, where are we right now? Where are we going over the next 3 years and say, this is how we want it set up? I think that's an opportunity that we didn't have at Studio D. And so I mm-hmm. want to say thank you to those who are supporting our Kickstarter campaign. And if you haven't done so already, it's cat5.tv/kick. And no, even though we've met the goal so that the show is safe, we're not going under. We're not going to close down. We are going to be on the air as soon as we're able to from Studio E. But everything that's raised beyond where we're at right now is just going to help us to build that set, make it as good as possible, make it as wonderful as we can so that we can really progress as a show, as a community, give you the content that you want and make it look as good as possible. I want the show to look really professional as well. I think we're at that point where Category 5 not only can be, but should be at that point where it just looks really good. I want it to look good for you so that when you sit down and watch it, you can say, hey, that's Category 5. I helped make that. I think that'd yes. be really cool.
Well, before the meeting closes down on us, I want to say to both you, Robbie, and Sasha, keep doing what you're doing because you guys rock. You rock.
Thanks, BP9.
As mm-hmm. do you. Thank you. Oh.
Well, I think we are out of time for our Zoom meeting. Quickly, any other comments or questions before we wrap up? I know we're going to get cut off here.
It happens so quick.
I know.
Time flies, doesn't it? Crazy.
We should do this again right away.
Yes, we're going to do this more often. I can imagine that we're going to do this quite often from Studio E, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Are you limited by how many meetings you can hold, or are you limited by how many meetings you can hold with Zoom or not?
I'm sorry, what's that?
Is there a limit on the number of meetings you can have?
Oh, no. The limits are that there can only be 100 people per meeting, okay. And the limit is timed to 40 minutes. But okay. I did find that the last one, they started cutting me off at 30.
Oh, nice. Oh, good. Okay.
So 100 is not bad, actually.
Yeah. So
we
from
have
Studio
five in here, right?
Yeah, from Studio E, we could have a fair few people participating in our Zoom meeting, and we could make that maybe just like a portion of the one-hour show.
You know what would be fun, actually? I know I'm just pitching an idea for an episode in the future.
Yes.
But could you imagine if, like, a certain number of people had exactly the same product and we were doing, like, an unboxing, a simultaneous unboxing and review all at the same time? That would be so much fun.
Can you imagine the chaos that would ensue when you...
So much chaos. Oh, I would love it. Let's do it.
That would be a lot of fun. I don't think that's been done before.
Where's Bo from Ameridroid? Are you going to send us some stuff to unbox?
Box, a gift from Ameridroid.
Oh, we need 100 Raspberry Pi 4s distributed around the world.
Yeah. And then everybody can come up with a unique twist on how to use it.
A combination C2 and Rock H64. Model B.
I'll take 100 of those.
Wow. those single board computers are rivaling desktops now in terms of power. That's crazy.
Yeah.
My single board computer setup. So I've got a few different. Oh, there's one up there too.
Yeah. I've been amazed at what a Raspberry Pi will do in terms of driving a normal Linux experience. It's amazing.
I just took down my PC, my Dell PC, and I've got Debian running on my Odroid H2.
Yeah, that's a nice one. The N2 is great. The Rock Pro 64 is great. They're all, to me, they're a lot more powerful than even the Pi 4, but the Pi 4 is the one that gets... the lion's share of the attention because of its popularity. Right. We also do carry those, but there's a lot of interesting single board computers on the market. I've got a N2 right here. This is actually one that runs the shipping department right now.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Don't drop it.
Wow. You probably can't see this big box right here. This box is all single board computers.
Oh, wow.
Right
can't
there.
See it, Robbie, because the
that's
shelf's
a big
in
box. It's like, yes. You know what? It's like 20 times the size of the Kleenex box.
I thought you had a printer in it.
The Scotty's box.
Scotty's box. I'm sorry. Scotty's box.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, thanks,
that's
Bill.
True.
Yeah. Oh, and they're all square in that square box, right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yes, exactly.
This box right here. See this box? That's all single board computers right there.
Now you switch back to the far camera again.
I don't know how.
Can you see
works.
Me now?
It might be just the Sasha. It might be just the audio. Whoever's talking might.
Oh, it's just the audio.
Yeah.
I can describe the box. It's like 16
it's
by 16, maybe.
It's bigger than 16.
I'm making things up.
Like every week, right?
That's all we can do.
I'm in so much trouble.
And on that note, thank you so much for joining us.
BP9
just cutting
is
us
doing
off,
his
boys.
Jeff Weston impression.
So listen, we are going to be back with more Zoom meetings for our Kickstarter supporters. So make sure you get over to cat5.tv/kick and participate. And we will see you next time. Take care, everybody. Bye.
Hey, you still got 10 minutes.
You think we really do?
It says, I have it on my screen.
Yes, it says 9 minutes, 45 seconds.
I don't want to take the risk, boys.
Okay.
Last time it cut us off and then I lost all the files.
Okay.
Plus, if we call a spade, I'm starving. I need to go.
You have packing to do, Sasha.
Yeah.
No, yeah, I need to pack things in my mouth and eat them.
We are out of here.
All right, guys. Okay. Take care. Thanks for coming back.
If you could see me, I would wave. But bye. Have fun.
Bye.
59. Take care, guys. Good night.
Good night.